Hello, everyone. And you know what time it is. I should hope by now you know what time it is. It was just on the screen. And if you don't know by now what time it is, I don't know what to tell you. I mean, it's not quite laser time because we have to find more lasers before it can be laser time. But it is time for The Witness. And like I said last time, it is time to head back to the Sun Temple, my favorite part of the game so far, to try to complete that. But before I do, there is one thing I want to go down here for, because I noticed last time that there was a door that I had not opened, and I guess I don't really need to open it, but hey, we are trying to solve all of the puzzles. It's this one right here. It has Tetris pieces. First time I was here, I did not know what to do with these pieces. What I do now, so let's see. We have these two shapes. Now, if I'm looking at this shape right here, I can't change the orientation, but I can't actually, like, draw it going to the right, because it's already all the way on the right, so that's not gonna work. So, let's see. How do we want to do that? It would be something... Maybe I could draw it. How do I want to get over there? Let's see. Maybe draw the shapes... Something like draw them both in the same zone. I could do it by doing, you know, like doing something like that is what I think it is. All right, this door is open. I don't really need it to be right now, not anymore. Well, maybe we'll use it some other time, I don't know, but it's open now, which makes things more convenient. Is that a... I don't know if that's a thing. Oh, that was for that door right there. We already did that forest up there a while back. Oh. Look out. Someone's hiding here. This guy. This guy thought he was hiding here the whole time. Thought he could get past me. But no. He could not get past my watchful eye. And yours too. I'm sure you saw him hiding right here. Let's see where this would end. Nope, not there. Alright. Let's see. Where would this have to go, do you think? What would be the place that should... Probably has to merge with a reflection, right? Oh, is that the end right there? Yeah, that looks like the end. Like... This, maybe? Yeah? Yeah? There we go. Still plenty on these that we have to find. Not as many on this one as others, I think. Seem like there are less puzzles on this. But that's not really what we're here to do right now. Eventually, we will be coming back to all of these obelisks to try to solve the environmental puzzles that are on all of them. And, you know, because that's what we're here to do. We're here to solve puzzles. We gotta solve all the puzzles before we can say that we are done witnessing. Can never truly be done until all the puzzles have been solved. And that includes the puzzles to be found in the Sun Temple, which, if you remember, this place was all about reflections and just sort of figuring out the right place to stand so you could see the solution of a puzzle, which, you know, there were like fingerprints rubbed onto the panels, and I didn't like that kind of puzzle. That was probably my least favorite puzzle so far. And like this thing right here, there's probably more lines that I have not done yet. I'm sure, like, there are lines drawn all over the place. I'm sure that there must be lines that I would be able to complete that I have not found. Let's see. I just want to take a quick look to see if I can find anything. Seems like that almost goes, but not quite. And that doesn't have an end either. Like, there is an end right there, but that thing blocks it. So, if I was able to find something that would get in the way of that, but I don't know what that would be. Like, almost right there, but not quite. Oh, right. And of course, to actually activate anything. Oh, right, right. So to get past that, it would have to be shiny. That's why I was able to do this. That's right. I'm remembering now how this goes. Right, like that. And I guess you already got that one. But what about... how would I have to stand for that one on the left to catch the sunlight? Because it's not catching it for whatever reason. I'm not sure why. But that one is not glowing. This one, right here. You! Why are you not catching the light and glaring? You should be. I guess it's because of this one's, like, looking in one direction slightly, and this one's facing in the other direction, which is why I guess it's not catching the light in the same way. I mean, it is catching the light right here, but that isn't. Which would prevent me from actually being able to... Oh, hold on, there we go. I must have already got... Did I already get that one? Maybe. Due to how bright this is, I can't tell if a line is already showing up there. Like, it's being blown out to me. And it's been so long since I've been here, I don't remember what I got and what I did not get. So that's kind of a problem. Then there are these other circles right here. I don't know if these are anything we can click on. Doesn't seem like it so far. What about this one right here? There is something, but the whole thing would have to be lit up for us to actually be able... Yeah, like, it was almost there. It was getting there. Not, that's not quite... But that's sort of what we would have to do. But I'm not standing in the right place for that, clearly. All right. I'm sort of putting this off. Putting off going into the temple, just because I don't really like this area. I don't like it. This was the area that I abandoned, because the puzzles had to do with raising and lowering a pool of water in one room, and the idea was that I would need to look at the reflections of the puzzles as the water was either going up or going down, and I would have to find a very specific place to stand so I would actually see the reflections of the puzzle in the water at a particular point in time, so I would know what the solution is. And that's apparently all there is to this, and I think this is the room. It looks like the room. Yeah, this door is closed. Can't really tell what that is over there, but we got a lot of puzzles done the first time we were here. So I have a feeling that we're actually almost done with this place. I don't think we have a whole lot more to go. But what do we have? We have this thing right here. Okay, I got those two. And okay, I guess this is the one that I'm on, right? If I get that one, then that will light up going to here. And if I get that one, then where does this cable go? Where's this going? I want to know where it goes. Where does it go? Goes along there. Oh, up here. And then across there. And then... where's that going? It's like, I guess it's going to this thing. And I guess we'll find out what happens if we can solve all these puzzles. What happens with that? Kind of looks like a spotlight or something. I don't know. All right. We're here. And apparently the only... apparently there's nothing else to know, nothing else to learn about this particular area other than I have to raise and lower water. And there's the reflection. I have to find the precise point where when the light reflects as the water is going up, I will see the solution on the panel. I think that's really all there is to it. And I was having a lot of trouble with that last time. Yeah, it's coming up. Taking its time, so, you know, I have a chance to see. And you can see the light right there in the water. So I would have to figure out what is the point I should be standing on to make sure that I'm actually able to see the glare coming off of that. Like, what is the actual spot I should be standing? It's almost at the top now, and I didn't see it, so it looks like I missed. So I guess this is the only light source, right? All right. That is the only light source, right there. It shines onto the water. Like that. And so any glare that I'm going to see has to come from that. There's not going to be anything else, right? Like, I don't well, would this light actually be able to do it? Because it's not really shining anywhere near it. I'm guessing that it has to be that light right there. Like, if I'm walking in the right place, then you can see, like, right there. It's sort of glaring on the reflection in the water. So what would be the proper place to stand to actually see that? What if I just stand straight right here and not move or anything? I don't know. Might as well try. No light shined on that. Let me just refresh my memory how I did the other ones here. Because it's been a long time. I just better make sure I'm thinking of this right. Yeah, okay, that's how I did the other ones. You can see the reflection on that right there, right? Like the light's shining down and catching that. And then as that one comes up on the left, like, I'm going to see the solution to that one, all right? So if that's the case, where do I need to stand for the light to catch this one on the right? Oh yeah, there's also something down here. What is that? Is that a reflection of something above? Yeah, because that's sinking down. Oh no, maybe not. Maybe that's a panel that's floating on the water. Oh, okay, so if this light turns on, then maybe I can get the glare on that one. Maybe that's how that's supposed to work. Also, something that's distracting me as I'm doing this is, like, this line right here, which kind of looks like an environmental puzzle, as well as that one. Like, if that one was an environmental line, where do you think you'd have to stand for that? Like, it would lower a bit, and then you'd be able to, you'd be able to get it as a circle. It's not working as a circle. Maybe I'm standing in the wrong place. Well, I know I'm standing in the wrong place for pretty much everything in this room. I'm not standing in the right place for anything. Nothing's working. Oh, wait. Is this the perspective? because I can see a glare. Will I be able to make it out here? Yeah. It's like it goes all the way around. I guess that's what that's doing. It goes along the bottom. Wasn't able to tell from there if you start from the left or to the right, but it looks like... It looks like it would either be like this, oops, or like that. No? None of those things. Did I look at it? Maybe I was thinking in reverse. Maybe it goes across the top, not the bottom. There it is. I don't feel good about that one. I'm not happy that I solved that. I just did it because I needed to advance, but I don't feel good or happy about making progress here. It's just something I have to do. Alright, so where's that? Where's that reflection? Where can I see that from? I can kind of see it from here. It's top and bottom, and then sort of like... Oh, I can't do it from here. Alright. It was sort of like this. Or maybe starting from the bottom. Oh, okay. It got covered with water. Something like that. Alright, and then that went along to here. Alright, I have to walk around to the other side. And then this light turned on. And does that mean that I'll be able to get that one now? Let's see. Can I get a glare? Can I get a glare? I don't know if I would actually get a glare from this perspective. Doesn't look like glare is happening. No. Let's see. Okay, what did that do for us? You have this spotlight, which is aiming down. Oh, that's what it did. That one over there. Alright, let's see if we can see that. I can't see the whole thing. It's being blocked. Yeah, a lot of that light is not shining past this column right here. So the this column is blocking most of the light that's shining on the reflection right there. But you can kind of see like it's going along the bottom, right? Or rather, that would be the top. So it exits out like this. But as it goes on, can I see the beginning of it, maybe? Like, some light is shining on it, but not all that much. I don't suppose it's like this. That seems like it would be too easy. It was not like that. Okay. Let's see, is there any light that actually can shine on that? Oh, hey, look at that. That actually worked this time. I'm just pulling the mouse along, seeing if this actually finds any purchase. All right. At least I feel kind of good about that one. It doesn't really look like any glare is going to get on the other side of that puzzle. At least not from here. Maybe I have to stand somewhere else to see the start of it. I'm guessing the middle is not going to be visible. I'm thinking that the middle is going to be, like, just blocked out, so I'll be able to see the end of the puzzle and the start of it. This is what's probably going to happen. And then just the middle of it will not... I'll not be able to see it because of this column blocking the light. At least that's what I'm guessing. But if I can see it, it's not going to be from here. Where would it be from, do you think? I don't know if... oh, hold on. There's something there. Something there. Okay. Yeah, part of it's visible. It's like in the middle... Like, you're starting from the top, then you're going down to the bottom diagonally, then across the middle, then maybe up? So, like, if I was looking at this, like, I start from here, right? And then... Where does that go from? Because it kind of looks like I'm going down diagonally, but I can't do that. Right? Maybe it goes like something like that. Maybe that's how that went. Let's pull it down again. Where was that? Okay, I think it's going to be around there. So it's what, something like, yeah, it's going to be like that, then down and across the middle, then up. Okay. Got that one. That sounded like a door opening. Yeah, the door did open. So what about this? What's this one? That seems strange. Well, I mean, I guess I'm going to go through the door, even though there's this one panel that I haven't done yet. I don't know how I would do it, because I don't know where the reflection would be, but I mean, this is open, and I don't like this level, so, I mean, I guess I'm going to go through it. I guess I'm going to take it and see what we have on the other side. Oh, look at that over there. That is a laser switch. And that is a laser crate right above me. What's over on the other side? Well, it looks like we have reached the final room of the Sun Temple. Of course, we did most of it the first time we were here, so it's not that much to go, fortunately. All right, so this one, let's see. Starting from, like, there, then going along, then there's, like, an S. Going along, and then there's, how does that go? Where does that go up? Like, it goes up at the very end. All right, so it's like this, and then kind of like that. No, it's not kind of like that. Or, like, is that the starting point? Like, is that circle right there? So instead it would be like that? No, it's not like that. I can kind of see it looking on the puzzle itself, I guess. It's kind of visible. So you do start from there. You go to the right. Keep going to the right, then down. So I like this? Oh, what am I thinking? That is another puzzle in itself. That has a different solution entirely, which is the one that I was looking at here. What am I thinking? And then we have this. So starting from here, looks like you go up. How far up should we go? It kind of looks like we're like doing this, I guess, and then comes down. But from there... Okay, so we went up and then down here, and then... So I'm guessing probably around like that. And then this? There we go. One of the laser things became unblocked. One of the laser things is unblocked. We only have one more thing before the laser is done. And what's that? Is that a puzzle? Yeah? Well, I can't do it because it's blocked. What puzzle is this? Oh, I can get around to the other side of it, though. Alright, so... would I just have to remember what that is? Well, we don't need to remember, because we have notes! I mean, that's what the notebook is for. It's what the pencil is for. And I am just going to draw that solution that I'm seeing in that reflection. I'm going to draw it down. Because why would I need to try to memorize that and then try to reverse it in my mind as I solve it from behind? Don't need to do any of that if we have notes that we can use. All right, I have drawn it. Now, I wonder what this does. Oh. That actually is the other laser thing. So, what's this one? Oh no, that goes to this, and then it goes to the laser. Is, I guess, how it goes, but why is this puzzle on if I haven't solved this one yet? I don't know. All I know is that we are going to try to do this right here. So, I think it's going to be... like this... It was indeed... like that. Right. I don't know why it powers this on, but this was already on, wasn't it? Is there... Oh. Okay, I gotcha. This is one of those rotating things, right? Yeah. It moves the panel. We've seen something like that before. Nope, not like that. Like that. And I guess that's all. And now, maybe we can just finally say goodbye to the Sun Temple. Even though there was that one unsolved panel back there, I guess I'm gonna have to go back for that at some point. But not right now. Right now it is laser time. What? You're aiming in the wrong place. You're supposed to aim at the mountain. Where are you aiming at? Where's this laser going? I thought we were shooting another one at that mountain, but apparently we are not. All right. I don't know what to think about that. That is puzzling to me. All the lasers so far have been aimed at one place and one place only, and that's the mountain. Now that we have activated the Sun Temple laser, which that's been the 10th laser I think we've done, it is shooting at a location across the ocean. And I don't think that boat is going to take us there. I wish it would, but I doubt it will. So what does that mean? I have no idea what that could mean. I mean, it has to mean something. Of course, we don't need all these lasers to open up the mountain because there were only 7 locks at the top of it. I haven't gone back up there, but I assume that we don't need it. But why would we have a laser shooting out in a completely different direction? One that does not actually... A location that is not actually on the island. A location that I assume we can't actually reach. Is that how that's supposed to go, or should I... Like, is there a way to reflect that laser back at the mountain or something? I don't know why there would need to be. Well, that is very puzzling to me. That's very strange. Why do we have this rogue laser? What's the purpose of this? Well, I don't know if there's anything we can do with this. I don't know if there's any way we can move it or anything. All I know is that this is aiming at just a location that is not on the island. It's just going across the ocean for some reason, and I don't know why. That's very curious. And that I'm looking at it back and forth, just trying to think of, is there something that I should be learning from that? And I don't know what it is. I don't know what I should be learning from that. I mean, is there something it's pointing at? Or is there something that I will need to bounce the laser off? Like, I don't know, like I'm looking at that up here. Like that. It looks like it's sort of on a tripod, isn't it? I wonder if you can turn that? The laser does go right by it. Like, right next to it. This is not activated. And there's a panel down here? I don't know why. It looks like it should go on there, but you can't actually pick anything up in the witness. I wonder if you can, like, turn this around and bounce the laser off of that. Well, I guess I would probably have to do more lasers in the town before I would know that for sure. More puzzles in the town. Because I did as many as I could last time and then just reached a dead end and then I decided to do other things. But now there's no time for other things. There are no other things to do. All the other areas have been completed. The other lasers have been activated, which means that the town is the only one left. This is the only area left to conquer before we head to the mountain. And there are puzzles that we could try. Like, what about this one? I mean, I know what the starbursts do now. Should probably give this one a try. That leaves three red on the right. Wait, there are three red and three purple. What would we do about that? So you need two of the same color to satisfy. And, you know, we can do two purple right there, two black, two yellow, two white, two blues, two reds. But, oh no, we have a purple and a red that are left over. They don't have a match. Being left by themselves will not satisfy the condition. And being matched with another color will not satisfy that condition. So that's odd. I wonder how you do this one, since that seems to go against the rules that we have seen so far. I'm just thinking about what I would even do with that, because... yeah, I don't know. That's an odd one. Yeah, that did not work. I mean, of course it didn't work. Because you're not gonna be able to get... like, on the left, that seems like that should be fine. On the right, though, you're just not going to be able to get pairs of everything. So there's going to be an odd number of each one, of the purple and the red. So that's puzzling. I wonder what that's about. Well, I guess we could try this. This looks like a lot of fun. We have five Tetris shapes. They are on the diagonal, which means their orientation can change. We have six purple bursts, so we are going to need to draw all these shapes. Let's see. So if you just wanted to separate things down here, we could do that like that. Like, so far the purple bursts have been satisfied. But what about these up here? What would we do with these? So, like this one is a shape, so let's combine it with... let's see. We could combine it with... how would we combine that with the shape to the right of it? We could do something. There's a lot of shapes that we're gonna have to draw here. It's kind of the problem. Unless I just wanted to try that and hope I get lucky. No, I didn't think that would work. That would have been too easy if that had worked. So how do we fit all these Tetris shapes here? That seems like some... How do we actually fit all these shapes? Because we have like that, and then we could do that, but then we have this extra one here. And if I did that, then... that, like, that, and that, then this one could, like, go down like that. And then, so it would be, like, drawing up. It would be, maybe I'll just give it a try. It would be, like, I don't want to, hold on, that's... I wanted to draw like that. That's right. So, maybe one way of thinking about it is that those Tetris blocks are all three blocks, and there are five of them, which means I need 15 blocks to actually fit all of them together. So each row is 5, 5, 10. Right now I have 18 blocks in this zone, which is too many. If I did that, I now have 16. Now I have 15. Does that actually fit everything? Does everything actually fit if I were to do it in this way? Well, only one way to find out. No, it does not. I do think this might be the right track that I'm on, the idea of counting the number of blocks here. Like, so right now I have 5, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. It won't work because the bottom of my shape is too long to fit all of these shapes. So that's not going to work. Let's see. Right now I have 5, 10, 14, 16. Let's see. Would that actually work? So right now I'm not even trying to figure out how to fit the shapes in here. Right now I'm just counting how many blocks I have to work with. Let's see, 5, 10, 15. Let's see, 5, 10, 14, 15. No, that's not it. I might be able to solve this faster doing it this way than actually working out how these all fit together. And if if I do, that's a valid way of doing it, right? Let's see, 5, 9, 13, 14, 15, 16, okay. No, I don't have, let's see. 5, 9, and 15. No, still not. So maybe I do need to, in addition to counting all these blocks, actually do try to work out how they could all fit together. It's 5, 10, and you have 15 right there. There we go. All right, so it's like I said, it was kind of challenging to try to hold those five Tetris pieces in my mind and try to figure out how they could all fit together. Maybe the faster way of doing it would just be to think about that I need 15 blocks, and I'm going to have to draw a shape that contains that, and there can only be so many of them. And, that ended up being a faster way of solving it. Blue light. And a power cable. And stairs going down. This is an ominous-looking room. What kind of room needs to look like that? That's a speaker. This speaker has been disassembled. And we recognize this, and also these. I think it was the bigger ones were the higher pitch, then the medium ones were medium, and then the smaller ones were lower pitch. I think that's how that went. All right. So what it's telling us here is that this would be an audio puzzle, except the speaker's broken. Isn't that fun? All right, what can we learn here? Are both of these supposed to be referring to the same sound? Because if it is, then that means there are four sounds. There are two high-pitched, one medium, one low. So there's not too many combinations. And in fact, that was the combination. That was it right there. All right. So it would have to be high, high. I have to get medium and then low. How do I do that, do you think? How would I be able to do that and make it to the exit? Not sure. Oh, what? No, okay, so that one turned off. So that one says it's solved, but I did a different thing. I did high, high, low, medium. What happens if I do it here? High, high, low, medium. And then this one turned off. The puzzles are registering as being solved. But whenever I solve one, the other one turns off. What if I... Let's see, what if I do this? Okay, so that was low, medium, high, high. And this one turned off. So I think I'm, you know, it's... I think I'm right about high, about the big ones being high. But, you know, I might be wrong. That's always possible, you know? It's been a little while since we've done those, so... I mean, it could always be possible that the large ones are low. That could be. I would have to refer to whatever the video was that we did this, because I would have written it down at the end of that. If it was, let's see. So if it was that, then if we're looking at small, medium, big, big, right? Small, medium, big, big. There we go. I'll have to go back, because I really did think it was that the big ones were the high pitch, but maybe they were the low pitch after all. Maybe I'm just remembering that wrong, which is entirely possible. Anyway, this went on, and stairs came down, bringing me up to this blue room, and it looks like it is time for some greenhouse action. It is time for some colored lighting. And we love that. You know we love that. We love all the colored lighting, but we only have blue this time. Oh, here's a room. Can I get anything? Any puzzles if I look out this window? Oh, I know. I think I know where I am. I'm on the other side of that one wall that had all those colorful flowers. Probably to get this environmental puzzle, I have to change the lighting to whatever the light needs to be, I'm gonna guess. But for right now, I guess we're just going to try some of this. Let's see, so I guess I can affect... I can decide which light I want to turn on, right? No? Oh, because these two have to be, these are white. Oh, well, these would be different colors, even though they don't appear to be. They appear to be black to me, but these would have to be different colors, which means that they have to be separated from each other, right? It's probably what's going on with that. So I could do this, all right? So we have some green light. And then from there, we would have to work out, what do we think? Oh, we have bursts here. We have starbursts. And we have normal dots. let's see. No. So how would you activate any of the others, do you think? All right, so that's how you do it. All right. So, let's see, what did I write down about colors earlier on? I did write quite a few notes when I was in that greenhouse. What did I write down about that? Let's see. It looks like... Just having a look at these old notes here. It said that, blue and magenta looked like black, orange and pink looked like gray, green and white equaled one. But it doesn't... Not actually seeing what colored light it was under. Okay. I'm looking at red lights. Let's see. Under red lights... Let's see, it was separated into black and white. Each colored lighting separated things into what appeared to be two different shades. I'm just trying to think about, does this help me at all? I don't know if these old notes are really going to help me when it comes to this, because I'm just going to have to figure out. Just going to have to draw new notes, I suppose, and figure out the groupings of these dots. So, if we're saying that we're looking at this under red light, and I'm seeing mostly white dots, mostly white, and at the bottom I am seeing black dots. So what I have to do is figure out the actual groupings of these. So I know what they are under red light. I'm just going to focus on the left panel right now, I think. Let's see. I would want to do this to turn on blue light. And when doing that, don't you love these color puzzles? We love them in the greenhouse, and we love them here. I don't know if these are the ones that have taken me the longest in this game. Not sure which ones have taken me the longest. The audio puzzles probably were among the ones that were the fastest, I think. But it feels like I spent a lot of time with these color puzzles. Anyway, that's blue. And now, turn on green. And we're going to draw down, of course, how these appear under green lights. All right, so what does this tell us? If we have all the notes, if we're looking at them all at once, what do we learn from here? Well, that upper right corner, that upper right quadrant, is white in all situations. Under any and all lights, it does appear to be white. So we could probably assume that the upper right are all one color, we might assume. Over on the upper left, under blue, the upper left square turns a different color than the rest, and the same thing under green. So, let's see. We can probably assume that three of them in the upper left all have the same color, and one of them does not. That one does not have the same color as the upper right, because when the lighting is green, they are different, even though they're the same under red and blue. Now, let's see. The lower left, under blue and green, the lower left quadrant are all the same. Under red, the upper right square turns different. So the other three in the lower left probably are all the same. Now, let's see. The lower right, under red and green, they all appear the same. But under blue, the upper right one appears different. So, are any of these different ones, do any of them appear to be the same? So let's see, the upper left one in the upper left quadrant, looking at red, blue, and green, let's see, does it appear? I'm checking to see if it appears to be the same as anything else, any other squares under the different lights. And no, it appears that it is not consistent with anything else. And I think it's the same with those other singled out squares. I don't think that they appear to be the same with anything else? I'm just looking at red, blue, and green. Just looking at them to see, do they change consistently with anything else? But it doesn't appear to be. Okay, so hope this is easy to follow. It's kind of hard to say when I'm sort of mumbling to myself while looking at a notebook. But I think it might be like something. We might be doing something like this. Oh, actually, it ends in the upper. It ends in the upper right-hand corner, doesn't it? All right, so how do I want to do that? I want to separate those from each other, right? I think is what I want to do. I want to separate those from each other. Now, I don't think having these two dots in the same zone, I don't think that's going to work, because those are not the same as each other. I don't think they're the same as anything, so how? I could cut it off by doing that. Like, that might be something I could do. And then maybe we could do something like, oh no, that, if I do that, then the lower left and the upper left are now in the same zone. And that's, I don't think that's going to work. I don't think those are the same. Yeah, I'm looking at, looking at this, at my notes, and no, those are not the same colors. I mean, I can tell that under green lighting, anyway, that those would not be the same colors. So I could do that, right? And then bring this up, and then yeah. And then, let's see, something like that to cut that off, I suppose. And then I could cut that off right there. And then all these are the same. No, that was wrong. Let's see. Why was that wrong, do you think? Let me just try to draw it again and try to figure out why this would not be correct. Oh, that's no. Let's see. So was it? Did I have the? No, that can't be how I had it. I don't think it could have been how I had it. Let's see. All right, it's something like that, I think. Okay, so from what I've drawn, in the upper left corner, those have been separated. And those, yeah, the different ones have been separated in the upper left, and they have been cut off from any other dots. The lower left, you have, yeah, those two have been cut off, and they're not in any other shared zone. The lower right, the ones that have been different, have been cut off, and they are not sharing any zone with anything else. And in the upper right, it appeared that those were all the same. So it seemed like that should be right. Oh yeah, okay, there it is. Yeah, I must have drawn it wrong the first time. Because that looks like that is what that is supposed to be. Alright, so that took a while, but it appears to be this is what we have to do. Okay, so you know what that means. Since we did it for one, we're going to have to do it for the other. Okay, let's start drawing some notes. And let's see. Let's see, how do I want to draw this? Okay. So we got the notes, we got red, we got blue, we got green. So now what we're trying to do is figure out, as we did before, what is the same and what is separate. Okay, upper left quadrant, we got red and blue are the same. Green, however, we can see that they do get separated. So that means that in the upper left-hand quadrant, there are some that need to be separated. Lower left-hand quadrant, let's see. Blue and green, they are the same, but under red, we do see that one of them appears to be different. And then, an upper right, let's see, same as blue and same under blue and green, but under red, one appears to be different. Lower right-hand quadrant, under red and blue, they appear to be the same, but under green, there is one that appears to be different. All right, so as before, I'm just going to think about any of those ones that that are the same, that are different. Would they be the same as any of the other different ones? Because these are starbursts, which means that they do have to be paired up with others. And it seems like that could potentially be a problem. So let's see. The lower left one in the upper left corner is different. And let's see. It remains white under red, green, and blue. And does any of the others do that? It does not appear so. Let's see. The upper right quadrant is black under all three lights. And the other two individual ones don't do that. The lower left one is white under red and is black under blue and green. The lower right quadrant is white under red and blue and black under green. So they are all different colors. All right, so that kind of presents a problem, doesn't it? From what we were learning about starbursts, you have to pair them up in the same zone. So you have two of the same color, right? So if you have these four individual starbursts that don't match up with anything, then what do you do about that? Well, let's see. I see what we do about that. Say in the case of in the one up here, this one. That one remains white under red, blue, and green. And so do these three. So these three, hold on, they have to be in the same zone as that, right? Now, for the, the lower left one right here. It's white under red and black under blue or green, which means these three. So this one has to get paired up. No, that doesn't work. Actually, that's kind of an odd thing. How do I get this out of here? Like, it looks like this one should be paired with these three, but it's kind of trapped here in the corner, isn't it? Right. But with starbursts, you don't need to separate them from other colors. You just need to make sure that they are paired up with another color. And in fact, you can't have more than one in the pair. So what I was talking about before, about how these three need to be here, that can't be quite right because there would be four. Rather, what we would need to do is what we need to do here, cut those off, and then you'd have two of the same color right there, right? So, let's see. This seems kind of complicated. So, let's see. We need to make sure that we have two of the same... we cannot have more than two of the same color in a zone. So, how do we make that happen? Oof, man. This does seem like kind of a tough one. How do we even do this? So, maybe this zone could... maybe it could contain... what could it contain? Maybe it could contain that. Nah, I don't know. I think maybe my brain is shutting down right now, trying to think about what it is we have to do here. I'm getting it, but when as I'm trying to think about what would I actually have to draw to make this happen, I don't know. It's not helping that I am seeing this in red light. So we have to make sure that there's no more than two matching starbursts in each zone, and sometimes two of the matching starbursts are across the grid from each other, like here and here and here and here. And let's see, I suppose that actually means that there are four colors in this, is what's probably happening. And I would need to, let's see, if there are, so four colors and four dots is one color. So 16 dots and four, each four dots are one color. So that means that there's going to have to be, that does that mean four zones? Would you need four zones then? I don't know. I can't really, I can't seem to think about it right now. So that's probably going to have to be it for this time round on The Witness, for no other reason that I apparently have stopped having the ability to think right now. Like, I don't really have any other reason to end the video but aside from that one. But it's a pretty good one, I think. Because if I'm not able to think, then I don't believe I'm actually going to be able to make any kind of progress, really, is how that works. Maybe I just need to give it some time and let this one stew in my brain for a bit. And then maybe it'll just come to me. Need to take some time to work that one out. Oh, yeah, okay. I thought it was green. But where would I need to stand to make that happen? Because apparently it's not there. Oh, hold on. There it is. Well, at least I was able to do that before ending today's video. That at least got done. What is that up there? It's like a whole lot of grids. Maybe it's just a wall. I don't know. It just caught my attention right there. But anyway, that's going to be it, I think, for this round of The Witness. So, I mean, at least we fired a laser. A laser that ended up going off in the completely different direction that we needed it to go. We attempted. Oh, yeah, we did finish the Sun Temple, so that's good. I mean, not having to go back there again, for right now at least, is a good thing. So we came back to the town, tried my hand at that. You know, it's taking some time. It's taking a bit of time to actually do this, because I was able to open this. And it led to a greenhouse, and I'm going to have to think about this one. I'm going to have to think about it. And then there's this weird one, in which there's, like, extra starbursts. And I'm not entirely sure what we would be doing about that. But I guess I don't need to think about that right now. Because we're ending today's video. We're ending today's video with some progress having been made, with a laser having been fired, and at least we're starting to make a dent in the town. Hopefully we'll be able to make a bigger dent next time, as I will solve these color puzzles. And then what happens after that, do you think? Like, if I do that, like this one's solved, what happens if I solve this one? I don't know. What do you think happens? Can we try to figure out what happens? Like, that's one side of the building. It's like that puzzle takes place in this orange area up here. I wonder if I solve that one, does like a wall open up? Because I'm not sure what else that would do. Yes, I know. We are feeling despair. Despair at the puzzles that Jonathan Blow has set out for us. And we'll look at the sky. We'll look at the sky together. As next time on The Witness, we'll continue on trying to make more progress. As we try to get through the town, don't know if we'll finish the town next time at this rate, but we will continue to try to do the town to get that final laser, which is up there. And then once we do, it's time to head into that mountain. We're getting there. Slowly but surely, we're getting there. I'll see you next time as we attempt to finish the town. I'll see you then. I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy for my shirt. So sexy it hurts. And I'm too sexy for Milan. Too sexy for Milan, New York, and Japan. I'm too sexy for your party. Too sexy for your party. No way. I'm disco dancing. I'm a model. You know what I mean. And I do my little turn on the catwalk. Yeah. On the catwalk. On the catwalk. Yeah. I do my little turn on the catwalk. I'm too sexy for my car. Too sexy for my car. Too sexy by far. And I'm too sexy for my hat. Too sexy for my hat. What do you think about that? Right Said Fred, 1991.